Dr. Brian Smith. I'm the Director of Bands here at Utah Tech University, and I'm so grateful that you can all join us. Welcome to all of you who are here in the audience, and welcome to all of you who are on the live stream. We hope that you are enjoying the concert, and hope that you will enjoy the rest of it. The first piece that we just played is called Early Light, and obviously draws little snippets from the national anthem, and mixes some around in some wonderful meter tunes. Makes for a really fun conduct, really fun play, really enjoyable one. So, hope that you enjoyed that. Before I go into our next piece, I want to make sure that I do what I really want to do, which is recognize those who are faculty here at Utah Tech who are here tonight. I see Dr. Rhonda Rhodes, our music education professor, is right here. Welcome to Rhonda. Great to see you. I see Laura, who is our marching band director. Welcome to Laura. Here in the house here, and I also know that behind me is my predecessor, my good friend, Maestro Gary Caldwell, who plays in the trumpet section. The next piece that we're going to perform is called the Capstone March. This piece is a piece that you probably have never heard before. In fact, I'll almost guarantee it. The piece is special to me. It was originally written 1892. It was written by Charles John Thomas, who actually came down here and lived in St. George, though he was originally from England, and went to Salt Lake City for quite a while. He became the leader of the Tabernacle Chorus at the time, up in Salt Lake City. And while he was up in Salt Lake, he wrote a piece of music for brass band called the Capstone March. It was written for and dedicated to the First Presidency of the Church of Jesus Christ of Saints for the ceremony of the completion of the exterior of the Salt Lake Temple. And if you can picture it, there were 40,000 people in the grounds when they laid that last capstone. And then the band, led by John Held, performed this piece of music. After that performance, I knew of no other performances of it, and so it sat in a box in the Daughters of the Utah Pioneers Museum until I found it during my doctoral dissertation. And I thought, we need to bring this back. So we did. So tonight, we're going to perform this piece of music. I do this in part because I've never done it, and I want to do it. And in part because we do have temples in this area that are currently being dedicated this year. And so for those who are of that faith, this is a celebration for them. But it's also an opportunity for me to perform a little bit of what they would have done over 100 years ago. So, this is the Capstone March. We hope that you enjoy it.
Thank you.
This particular concert is being done in conjunction with our annual conducting symposium. We bring in conductors from all over the region and the nation to come and learn about conducting, music education, rehearsal techniques and such. And we're just grateful. We've had two wonderful clinicians with us so far, and we'll have them again tomorrow. Unfortunately, one of our clinicians was unable to join us this evening for the concert. He's running a jazz concert in Cedar City tonight as well. He's a busy guy. But that is Dr. Adam Lambert from Southern Utah University, and we are grateful for him. Even though he's not here, I want to give him a round of applause because he's a good man and he's doing good work. So. Our other clinician is someone who is very near and dear to my heart. Alan Tino currently is at the New England Conservatory of Music. He has done wonderful work with youth for 40 years, plus years, I think is probably a better way to put it. But I know him best as my high school band director, or as Mr. B. He was my band director, and he was one of the people who was very influential in my life to help me get going in the music world. And gratefully, he accepted the invitation to be one of our clinicians to work with all the wonderful people at the symposium and to conduct his band this evening. The piece that is going to be performed is a piece that he has done multiple times. He has a long history of going to Japan and bringing groups to Japan and performing with the Japanese bands back there. And my goodness, they're wonderful over there, aren't they? And so he requested to do a Japanese piece this evening called Aim to the Infinite Sky. And so I'm going to turn the podium over to my good friend and mentor, Alfred Dentino, at this time. Please welcome Alfred.
Oh,
piece of music that we're going to do is called Shine. Shine is a brand new piece of music. Utah Tech was on what we call a commissioning group. That means that certain people from various universities and high schools paid some money for a composer to write a specific piece of music for someone or for something. In this case, we joined the consortium to write a piece of music for our good friend Diane Solberg, who just retired from Brigham Young University, Idaho. She was one of our guest clinicians here a few years ago for the conducting symposium. She's a wonderful oboe player, an absolutely delightful person, and just somebody who we highly respect. And I thought it would be really worth it to put some money in to have Alyssa Morris write this next piece of music, and she did. It's only been performed once or twice, once on the original performance date for Diane on her retirement concert, and then I think it's been performed one other time, so this is probably performance number 3 in the world. It's exciting, it's a beautiful piece of music. Obviously focuses on oboe, so Brooklyn's going to be playing a bunch of oboe for us tonight. It also features Sheldon on our flute, and they do some wonderful things together. And then you're going to hear Corey on the piano, who's going to give us some wonderful notes as well. It's a beautiful piece, and we hope that you enjoy Shine by Alyssa Morris.
Thank you.
tomb there, came back to the United States and asked the staff, the military staff composer and arranger to write a piece for him, an arrangement of it. That staff composer is somebody who we know very well, especially in the jazz world. His name is Sammy Nestico. And Sammy Nestico wrote this wonderful piece for President Kennedy, and it was his unofficial march. And so we're going to play that for you right now. This is The Boys of Wexford. For this conducting symposium, we've had a couple of pieces which are on the example list, I guess you could say. And what happens during the symposium is we have people who come up and they conduct this band. We'll have 10 conductors over the course of 2 days. And then our two clinicians will come up and they will critique them and say, well, you did this, you did that, try this. And the band's job is to do whatever they do. The final piece we're going to play for you tonight is one of those example pieces. We're going to do Imaginarium by Randall Standridge. And we're going to play it the way that I like to conduct it. So hopefully you like it. All of you who conducted earlier today, you're totally cool with your interpretations. This is mine. So, by the way, can we do this real quick? If you are a participant in the symposium, Parker, you stand. I can see you out there. Come on. Okay, everyone, sir. This is a great opportunity to learn and grow. I've been to symposia myself and been on the podium and been ripped apart, ripped to shreds. I know where the clinician was, and it was good for me. And I hope that these wonderful people enjoy their time here. So thank you for coming and joining us, participants. And thank you to each of you for coming and enjoying this performance. There are many more at Utah Tech coming up. Tis the season. There will be a lot of them coming up in the next month. If you are in my concert attendance class, tis the season. Get your reports in, please. Thank you so much. They're laughing because they're in the class. They know. Get those reports in, and get them due. But thank you so much for being here this evening. We hope you enjoyed it. Come to more of our concerts here at Utah Tech, and we will see you next term when we do some more wonderful music with the UT Symphonic Band. This is Imaginarium by Randall Stanton.
Earlier today when he was like, I don't need the score when they're out on the stage. I'm trying to decide if I can.